The U.S. Navy has received delivery of two Freedom-class Littoral Combat Ships, LCS. These are USS SiouxCity and USS Wichita. The two vessels are the 14th and 15th LCSs to join the U.S. Navy, and the 6th and 7th of the Freedom-class vessel. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why Littoral Combat Ship, LCS, is an important addition to the U.S. Navy. Let's get started. The Littoral Combat Ship is a set of two classes, the Independence and the Freedom. Construction of the Freedom class is spearheaded by Lockheed Martin at Fincantieri Marinette Marine Shipyard in Wisconsin, while that of Independence class ships is led by Austal USA in Alabama. These are relatively small surface vessels and basically designed for operations near shore. During the late 1990s, the U.S. Navy understood that cruisers and destroyers would be vulnerable to attacks in shallow coastal waters. Large warships like cruisers and destroyers are designed for open water warfare and not for shallow water, where these can be targeted by high-speed boats, missile-firing fast attack craft, small submarines, sea mines, and layer and launched anti-ship missiles. The idea behind the Littoral Combat Ship, as described by former Secretary of the Navy Gordon R. England, is to create a small, fast, maneuverable, and relatively inexpensive member of the DDX family of ships. If required, these ships will absorb an attack and protect the much more expensive cruiser or destroyers. The LCS is envisioned to be a networked, agile, stealthy surface combatant capable of defeating anti-access and asymmetric threats in coastal waters. Interestingly, the LCS has a modular design. The vessels can be configured with different modules for specific roles that includes anti-submarine warfare, mine countermeasures, anti-surface warfare, intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance, homeland defense, maritime intercept, special operations, and logistics. In the long run, the LCS are expected to slowly replace slower and specialized ships such as minesweepers and amphibious assault ships. Freedom-class LCSs have a displacement of 3,400 long tons, being 150 meters in length. These have a top speed of 87 kilometers per hour, a range of 6,500 kilometers, and endurance of 21 days. In a standard configuration, Freedom-class LCS's armament consists of 11-cell Raytheon RIM 116B CRAM missile defense system, BAE Systems Mark 110 57mm naval gun, and Mark 50 lightweight torpedoes launched from torpedo tubes. RIM 116B CRAM missile defense system can launch Mark 31 rolling airframe missiles that have a range of 9 kilometers and has a speed of Mach 2. The 57mm naval gun is designed for close-range combat and has a range of 1.7 kilometers. Mark 50 torpedo is a U.S. Navy's advanced lightweight torpedo for use against fast, deep-diving submarines. It has a range of 15 kilometers and speed of 40 knots. Freedom-class LCS also accommodate one MH-60RS Seahawk helicopter or MQ-8 Fire Scout unmanned autonomous helicopter. In future, LCS will also be armed with a 24-shot vertical launch system that will be able to launch AGM-114L Longbow Hellfire missiles. The missiles can carry 9-kilogram warhead and has an 8-kilometer range. Furthermore, the Anti-Submarine Warfare (ASW) warfare package is expected to become available by next year, and the Mine Detection and Clearance package by 2020.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.